The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Gators' offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
The thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
From their own 37-yard line, first down. He's going to try and scramble. Defensive end was the victor on that play as he bolted in to tackle him for a loss.
And he was able to do that because the interior linemen held their ground, leaving the runner with no options.
Third down at 15. Ball on the 32-yard line. Once and all, going deep. Incomplete. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. Play was very well defended. Now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
It's away and it's a booming punt. The ball is loose. It's picked up. To the 20, to the 10. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. He makes the PAT, a five-play, 34-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. The score now, 7-0. Florida is lining up to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, let's see if the offense can make up for the misfortune they had just a few moments ago.
Brad, it's very important that this offense put that last possession behind them and just focus on trying to put together some positive plays right now and see if they can put a drive together.
Missed him. The defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Brought down at the 43, and that was an excellent run there.
Yeah, Brad, but it was also great blocking up front by the offensive line to open up the hole.
Zips it to the tight end, and he's taken down at the 44-yard line.
If you're the defense, who do you try to cover this guy with? He's too fast for most linebackers. He's too big for most corners. You have to rely on your safeties, who generally aren't very good in one-on-one coverage.
Runs with it, and he's got room. He lost the ball. That was a close one, but the ball goes out of bounds. It's first and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's taken down at the 27.
Number 15 makes the touch ball at the 27-yard line.
Three down.
That'll make it second and four.
Kill!
Give to the tailback, and he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. They try to counter Trey there, but the defense read it nicely.
It's amazing the read and recognition skills of these linebackers. They just always seem to have a beat on the play.
He's out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, looks long enough, and he nails the long field goal. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Got to wonder right now which offense is going to open this thing up a little bit.
I think the answer will be which offensive coordinator is willing to take a chance or two to try to open some plays up. Because right now, not only are they losing the battle up front, but they're really not testing the defense downfield at all.
Florida is up four. Nice run there. He kept it himself and picked up about 6 yards. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Take four.
Here we go. 390.
They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. It out to about the 46. From their own 46-yard line, it's first down.
Ready, right, 80.
He's scrambling. He's wrapped up for the sack. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Takes the ball inside.
Call it a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it 35.
The 39-yard line.
Number 58 on the tackle at the 39-yard line.
From the 39-yard line, first down. Florida is up by four. He airs it out, and it's intercepted. And he's level at the three.
Not only did he demonstrate his leaping ability, but he also has the hands to be able to pull the ball in. Great job.
First down. Got to be careful down here, deep in your own territory. And he gets a yard on the run.
And that was a sophomore linebacker there who was able to get in and make that tackle.
That makes it second and 10.
And they make the stop at the 7-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three.
That'll bring up third and six.
And he's tackled at about the 15-yard line. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
Start offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still first down.
So the penalty will make it first and 15.
Roger. Mike 12. Black five.
Got it. And he goes down quickly.
Good work here by the defense to keep him from making something more out of that play.
Of two on the run by the halfback.
That is a loss of 2 yards.
after one quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. Florida leads 7-3. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks.
Three down.
12's the mic.
Dog, four.
Blue go.
Makes the catch, and look out. He gets hit out of bounds at the 29-yard line. Good gain on the pass to the running back.
This young man is becoming more and more part of this passing game. He does a great job of making guys miss after the catch.
Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield.
Well, give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
This is the ninth play of this drive. Throws it to the outside. And down he goes at the 49-yard line. Fires complete over the middle. Tackle made right around the 36-yard line. Out to around the 25. He gets rid of this one. Play 13 of the current drive. At the 8. He has some room. Touchdown, Tennessee.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. And he hits the PAT. Tennessee is ready to kick it away. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, everywhere we go and we travel all over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread or the pistol. Hurry up, tempo offense and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
Tackled for a loss. Second down and 14. Ball on the 21-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 37-yard line.
That's a gain of 16 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
He makes it to the 38-yard line.
That's a deep run. That makes it 7-8.
From their own 38-yard line, second down.
45's the mark.
Let's go. Great run.
And now he's got room to run.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
First down.
The halfback picks up a yard.
That makes it second and ten.
From the 47-yard line, it's second down.
Let's go! 180!
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Fires quick. He catches another. Brought down around the 36-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards.
First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Out of bounds at about the 35. And this is the ninth play of the current drive.
That makes it second and 10.
Fires it out. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 45. Check Mike 45.
Ready. Wide 80. Wide.
And he's taken down around the 23-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From the 23-yard line, it's first down. Steps out of bounds right around the 20. This is the 12th play of this drive. Gets it. He's in space. That's a great tackle at the 16-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it.
Well, they'll line it up again on third down. Two for two so far on this drive. Decent run here, right side. They're really putting a nice drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
He's taken down around the 1 yard line. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. And this is the 15th play of a very solid drive. They line up in the jumbo set. Quick throw in the end zone, touchdown.
That'll be a big boost. You always want to capitalize on these short yardage situations, and that pass was an excellent call.
And he converts the extra point. Florida, the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Throws complete, big loss. Loss of five there.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
Dumps it out left to the running back, and he hits him hard at the 30. Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line.
After
a decent decent run up the gut.
Well, that's a great job by this offense. The defense knew that the run was coming, and they still could not slow them down. Pick up a first down and allows them to continue to work this clock.
Throws out, got his back again. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Kill, kill, kill. Yellow three.
Yellow three.
That'll bring up second and 11.
We've got a great game here, folks, as we reach the end of the first half. The Gators lead it by four.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Defense has been dominant in this game. Yards very hard to come by. But David, as we get deeper and deeper into this game, the natural assumption is that the pressure goes to the offense to do something.
Yeah.
How much pressure is on the defense not to make that catastrophic mistake?
Well, that's the conundrum you get in. I mean, it makes it exceptionally tough because you want to play perfect and you want to get them to punt every single time, but it's not the way it works. And it's those big plays that you usually see that kill the defenses and break their backs. And you can hold them great, Reese, on first down, second down, it's third and long. You're in a perfect situation. You give up that one play for 80, and it changes the whole complexion of the game. So I think you got to have a little bit of both. It can't just be great defense the whole time. Usually the teams that play great defense can keep you in it, but only for so long. At some point, that offense has to get something going.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They'll give it off here. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. Middle of the tight end. They'll bring him down around the 26-yard line. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Easy, easy.
He airs it out. Inside the 30. It's complete. The 10. Touchdown, Vols. Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he adds the extra point. Tennessee, kick this one off. Excellent kick. And they can forget about returning this one. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. 3-yard gain by the running back.
That was the junior linebacker who'll get credit with the tackle there.
That'll make it 77.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. He's on the run. He's tackled at the 37.
Makes the tackle. That's a gain of nine on the play. First down.
Tight left, tight left. Four down. Hey, check Mike 45.
Set. Check.
Fires to his receiver. First down.
Number 17 makes the tackle at the 48-yard line. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 48.
Three down.
45's the mark.
Set. Green.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and 3.
They're packed in tight on the line. And he is drilled at the 38-yard line. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Nice run there.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
Three down.
Hey, check Mike 45.
Gets out to about the 31. From the 31-yard line, second down. Throws this one away.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive.
Here we go. Wide 80. Wide 80.
There's a strike complete. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. 3-yard loss there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
So it's fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Florida is looking to tie things up. It's up, looks long enough, and he nails the long field goal. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Kirk, you and I like seeing points. We're seeing points in this third quarter. This has been fun.
And I think it's going to continue, Brad. I think the adjustments that were made at halftime have allowed these quarterbacks to go out and really be able to take command of how they want to attack each defense. It's going to come down to that final drive.
Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count.
Three down.
Check Mike 12.
Throws out and through his hands.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
And two.
Throws it in a hurry. And he's tackled at the 49. Sends it out quick, intercepted. And he's level at the 37-yard line.
Well, he was facing a big pass rush. The ball had no chance of being caught by one of his teammates. That's what pressure will do for any defense.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line.
Check my 45.
Sit up. White 87.
He's going to try and scramble, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Second and 11.
You don't want to go one
now.
Pick up the ball.
45's
the mic. Ready.
Now he tries to buy some. time. Tackle made at the 36. From their own 36-yard line. Third down. Caught open field at the 30. The 10. He scores. What a play. He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Gators staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around kids like this. They're just fun to be around.
They're fun to be around, and I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really throughout the entire team. It's no wonder this team is so competitive with him at the front leading the way.
And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Second and 10. Ball on the 25.
Red, two. Hey, kill, kill, kill. Black,
hit as he threw, and he completes it. They'll drop in for a loss. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Quick throw out to the receiver. And they make the stop at the 34. Well, they get all those yards, but come up just shy of the first.
Good play call, almost perfect execution, except for the fact that they're not going to get the first down.
Oh, excellent punt. He's tackled at the 27-yard line.
The Volunteers have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake. What was that?
And folks, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. Florida's lead is a touchdown. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Florida is up by a touchdown.
Let's go!
And down he goes, right around the 48-yard line. So it's second and 10, ball on the 48-yard line. To the halfback on the screen. Tackle around the 37-yard line.
Number 17 makes the tackle at the 37-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
From the 37-yard line, first down. To the receiver, and it's knocked away. Now he's scrambling. Brought down at about the 19-yard line.
first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 19.
Hey, let's get this, get this.
Ready?
Check, check. Big down.
Gets to about the 17-yard line. Florida is up a score. Carries the ball for a nice game.
That'll bring up third and four.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
Four down, 45's the mark.
Ready.
Fires out to his wideout. He's taken down at the 9.
Brad, you can really feel and sense the energy coming from the sidelines right now. They know how important it is to pick up first downs. And the coaches right now are showing the excitement that they have and yelling out the next play for the offense. But clearly, the offensive coordinator is very happy about the execution on that last play.
Check, check. Eagle! Eagle! Hut, hut!
Touchdown, Gators!
This guy seems to make things happen no matter what kind of space he has to work with. All he needs is a little crease of daylight and forget about it.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
Just under three to go in regulation. And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Quick pass. He sheds it. He steps out
at about the 37-yard line.
Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Wears it out to the right to the halfback.
That makes it 7-6.
Mike 12.
Hey, kill, kill, kill.
Fires it out. Not going to keep the drive going.
Good, solid defense there to force them into a fourth down situation.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Five wide.
Mike 12.
Completes the pass, but a great stop by the defense. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. And he's taken down at the 27.
Anytime this guy carries the ball and gets a little space, we could be talking about six.
First and 10. Ball on the 27. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. A one-yard gain by the halfback. The Volunteers call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Bring him down around the 26-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go. Tennessee's out of timeout. Scrambling around. He's tackled around the 25-yard line. Fourth down. They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, and it's good.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
34-17, Florida. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And they can forget about returning this one. I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. Chucks it downfield. The junior makes the catch. What a tackle. That was going to be a touchdown. That's a first down as they hooked up on the deep route.
And the defender just got outrun and outplayed by the receiver. He wanted it more, and that allowed him to make a heck of a play.
Spikes the ball. From the 25-yard line, it's second down. And he is drilled at the 22.
Kill, kill, kill. Yellow three.
That'll bring up
yellow three. Green nine, green nine. Green 15.
Motion, motion,
motion. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And he's tackled around the 3-yard line.
Kill, kill, kill. Number three.
And so that's going to do it. The Gators get the win, 34-17. As we wrap this game up, Kirk, what final thoughts do you want to share?
Florida came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.